Advent service. Thanks for being along on the journey with me. It's been really a pleasure to help facilitate these services, and thanks for all you contributed to really, really nice Advent midweek dinners as well. Really appreciate all the support received there. As in previous weeks, as an insert in the bulletin, has the readings on one side, and the other side are the two hymns that will be seen during the course of this evening's worship. And Sunday, Gary, just a reminder to everybody, Sunday morning, which will be the fourth Sunday in Advent, one service at 9:30. So just to help to reinforce that, one service at 9:30 in the morning on Sunday. We'll be observing Advent 4, also be singing some carols in there. And then the evening service, 7:30, our service of Holy Communion, 7:30 in the evening, Christmas. We bring together the service of light. Please stand.
Jesus Christ is the light of the world.
When he was 12 years old, they went up according to custom. And when the feast was ended, as they were returning, the boy Jesus stayed behind in Jerusalem. His parents did not know it, but supposing him to be in the group, they went a day's journey. But then they began to search for him among their relatives and acquaintances. And when they did not find him, they returned to Jerusalem, searching for him. After 3 days, they found him in the temple, sitting among the teachers, listening to them and asking them questions. And all who heard him were amazed at his understanding and his answers. And when his parents saw him, they were astonished. And his mother said to his son, "Why have you treated us so? Behold, your father and I have been searching for you in great distress." And he said to them, "Why were you looking for me? Did you not know that I must be in my father's house?" And they did not understand the saying that he spoke to them. And he went down with them and came to Nazareth and was submissive to them. And his mother treasured up all these things in her heart. And Jesus increased in wisdom and stature and in favor with God and man. This is the word of the Lord.
Thanks be to God.
Please be seated. Our second hymn is on that insert your bulletin, "Angels in the Realms of the Lord."
Thank you.
we had what we call the visitation. And we met Mary, now with child. She travels a number of miles, and she visits with her relative and friend, Elizabeth, who is pregnant with John the Baptist. And Mary stays with Elizabeth for three whole months. This beautiful story reminds us of the importance of Christian friendship, the open door, the listening ear, being there with one another in good times and in the not so good times. And so tonight, we have a final reading from Luke's Gospel, which you just heard. It comes at the tail end of what we call a Christmas narrative, and Mary comes to us once again to help us so that we not emerge from Christmas deflated, but encouraged and energized. Luke in his Gospel, chapter 2, basically tells the whole story of Jesus on earth. Mary and Joseph travel back. There's no room in the inn. They find lodging in the stable. Mary gives birth to the Christ child. The shepherds abide in the field, hear the angelic announcement. They go and see the child for themselves. And then in verse 19, it says that Mary, in response to these events of the first Christmas, quote, treasured up all these things and pondered them in her heart. Then the narrative moves on. Jesus is in the temple with his parents. He's still an infant. Simeon scoops him up and sings a song of praise to God. Let your servant now depart in peace, according to your word. I've seen your salvation with my own eyes, and the prophets have come forward over, and it says, I've seen the Messiah. And she likewise praises God. Thank you, God, that I've lived long enough to see this. And the narrative moves on very fast, and by the end of that single chapter, Jesus is not now a boy. Luke chapter 2. His whole thing is told in Luke chapter 2. And now at the end of the chapter, he's a boy. His parents take him along on a pilgrimage to the temple in Jerusalem. And you know the story. On the way back, they get separated. And just like many parents, we're kind of panic. They're looking around and they can't find him. They go running back. They're a day's journey out. They go running back. And they find a way in the temple. And a little conversation ensues. He says to them, I must be about my father's business. And then all the way at the end of the chapter, the chapter 2, verse 51, echoing verse 19, and Mary treasured up all these things in her heart. It says that again. Twice in the same chapter, Mary treasures up, quote, treasures up all these things in her heart. Verse 19, she ponders them. The word treasure here literally means she guards these things closely. She keeps these things very close to herself as a precious treasure. Just as if you went to the store tonight and you bought a very expensive ring, diamond ring. You'd go to great pains to make sure you didn't leave it in the store. In the way home on the car, in the car, you want to know exactly where that ring is. Then when you get in the house, you'd make make sure exactly where you put that ring. And keep close. Keep close.
So I can go to the store and take out a couple, or a man take a couple $1,000 on you. You want to keep that close to you, right all the way home. Mary treasured these things that she had seen and she experienced. Treasured and keeps them close to her heart.
Ponder. It says she treasured these things and she pondered them. And the word there suggests you have this precious thing and you take it out and you, from time to time, examine it. And you look at it. And you think about it. And you contemplate it. And you keep drawing blessing from it. A cartoon in New Yorker magazine. New Yorker magazine is entitled The Morning After. And in this little cartoon, there's pictured a dried up, withered Christmas tree. And the calendar on the wall in the background says December 26th. And the father sitting in his recliner with an ice pack on his head. He obviously had a little too much to drink on Christmas Day. And the mother standing there like this. Her hair's up in curlers. She's in a bathrobe. And all over the floor are wrappings and ribbons and bolts. A big mess. And the kids, already bored with their toys, are playing with the boxes they came in. So what is the end to what you might call a post-Christmas slump? And Mary, the Virgin Mother of our Lord, gives us the answer. As Christmas comes again, as we hear the story of Christ coming among us in great unity, hold it close to your heart. Keep it as a precious treasure. And in the coming days and weeks and months, continue to ponder, examine, contemplate, think about it, examine in your heart and in your mind. For God so loved the world that he gave his only begotten Son, that whoever believes in him should not perish, but have eternal life. We join together in singing Mary's song, the Magnificat. It's pretty important. Please stand.
Hey, thank you.
Thank you. Father, we receive the offerings. You see it as we join together in the litany, page 4 of the book.
In peace, let us pray to the Lord.
Who live and reign with you and the Holy Spirit, God forever.